All right. Thanks, Nick. Thanks to everybody for being here today. Feels cool to have this again. First time in 4 years that we've been able to do an in-person media day, and a lot of excitement around both programs. And I want to acknowledge Coach Wheeler and his new position and thank him. He's been great with me over the last month or 6 weeks. Has even been transporting me around a little bit as I haven't been able to drive. And I want to wish him and the guys team luck. It's so important to have both hockey teams be strong here at UVM, and I'm really excited to see his first season at the helm. I also want to thank Little Caesars for providing us with some food today. Was there another sponsor out there? I don't know. Was there anybody else? Yeah. No, I was going to, but I didn't know if there was someone else there. But and also the folks at the Windjammer, the Best Western Windjammer, Tom O'Connell, Jeff Bushy, and the gang, always such big supporters of our program, and happy that they've continued on with us through thick and thin. This is a new season for us. We graduated a very impactful group last year, and we're really mindful of the opportunity that we have to take another step, to integrate a lot of new faces into our program, and really kind of embrace the challenge of this new era. What I hope is a new era. I just want to highlight a couple of the new faces that we have in our program. We've got Alex Gettens in a new role as associate head coach. We've got Victoria Blake on working with our defensemen and our penalty kill. Been really great to have her here for the last 6 weeks, and to get to know our players and our system and our style of play. And I'm really confident in her ability to help motivate our student athletes and to raise our compete level. And we have a new strength coach too that's also fit right in and really is invested in our program and pushing our kids. Phil Currier came here from Maine this year. But importantly, we have 8 freshmen, 8 new players on our roster this year, and a lot of playing time is up for grabs, both for the returners and for the new players. And these 8 have fit in so well with our culture and are competing really hard in practice and getting up to speed. But it does present new challenges that we haven't necessarily had over the last couple of years. For one thing, first injury report of the season, I'm out indefinitely. I'm not going to be able to be on the ice for at least a few months. And so, of course, with a new coach and a lot of new players, that presents a unique challenge. And Alex and Vic and Danny Roberts, our other assistant, have done a great job on the ice getting our players up to speed. But I think that, losing this impactful class, we could look at it and say, oh, we've got big holes to fill. And of course there are holes. But I think we could also look at it and say there's great opportunities for other people to step up into roles that they hadn't played before. And that includes returning players and freshmen. I think that managing our expectations is such an important part of this season. Coming off these two good years and with preseason polls picking us nationally or recognizing us nationally and in Hockey East, I think it would be natural to feel the pressure. And I think, if anything, to me, it's a measure of the respect that we've gained from our league coaches and from coaches and whoever else votes in these polls. But by the same token, I think we look at it as an opportunity that we still feel that we have a lot to prove as a program. We want to get past the semifinals. We want to have the opportunity to compete for a Hockey East championship and potentially get to the NCAA tournament. So we really are looking at the season like a marathon. It's been tempting over the last couple of years with a veteran lineup to come out and think like we can really be almost at our best right from game one. Look, if that happens this year, that would be great. But I'm very mindful that we have a young team, a lot of new people to integrate, and that it's going to take a little time for our team to develop. And that if we if we develop the way I think we can, I have no doubt that we can compete for a championship at the end of this season. Just want to highlight a couple other things here. We got a great leadership group. Natalie Milinkova is our captain. We have four assistant captains in Sarah Levike, Haley Burns, Elena Tansky, and Maddie Skelton. It's an unusually large number, but we also have a lot of newcomers, and we thought it was important that we had a really good group of formal leaders to help integrate that freshman class. And just one last thing, just want to highlight a couple of scheduling things here. We do have two big early season tests right off the bat, starting in the weekend. After this weekend, we've got Clarkson and St. Lawrence coming here, two of the really strong teams in the ECAC, and I think it's gonna set us up very well for Hockey East play. We've got the Pack the Gut game a little earlier this year on November 11th, and I hope that with a big crowd, we'll give them something to be excited about and maybe continue to build on the attendance that we've had over the last few years later in the season. And then finally, I just want to say we have the opportunity to play three Saturday night games this year. It doesn't happen often, including one where in 2 weeks when our men are playing their exhibition game at 2 and we're playing at 7. And I'm hoping that the people that love hockey, that are used to going to hockey games on a Saturday night here, will give us a chance as well. So a lot to be excited for, and I think a really motivated group and excited to get going this Sunday against McGill at 4 o'clock for our exhibition game.